Good morning, students. Today we will discuss the apparent weight of a man in a lift or elevator. Apparent weight of a man in a lift or elevator. So there are so many cases when the lift is at rest, when lift is moving with uniform velocity in upward or downward, or lift is moving in upward with acceleration, downward with acceleration. So different cases will arise. Now this is a lift, and in this lift there is a weighing machine to check his mass, that means weight, to check his weight. And suppose the mass of the person is 10 kg. So what will be its original weight? Therefore, mg, and this will act a action on the floor of the lift, that means on the weighing machine, and so weighing machine will give a reaction force. And this is R, reaction force . This mg will act on the weighing machine, so this is the action, and reaction, the weighing machine will give reaction force on the person, and this is equal to say R. Now first case is when the lift is stationary. Lift is stationary. Then A equal to 0. Body is at rest, so there is no acceleration. So what will be the net force? Net force equal to 0. Therefore, what is the net force? R minus mg. R minus mg equal to 0. Equal to R equal to mg. So apparent weight will be equal to the actual weight. Apparent weight will be equal to the actual weight when the lift is stationary. Apparent weight is equal to the original weight. Now when the lift is moving upward or downward with uniform acceleration, second case, when the lift has uniform motion in upward or downward direction. In this case, what will happen? Same. In this case, A equal to 0. A equal to 0. So net force equal to 0. Therefore, R minus mg equal to 0. So R equal to mg. So apparent weight equal to actual weight. So you see, when moving with uniform motion, then acceleration zero. If it move upward or downward, no matter. So A equal to zero. A equal to zero. What does it mean? Net force equal to zero. So R minus mg equal to zero. So R equal to mg. So in this case also, the apparent weight will be equal to the actual weight. Now suppose, third case, the lift is moving with uniform acceleration A in upward direction. Lift is moving with uniform acceleration A in upward direction. So since the lift is moving upward, so this is greater than this. The net force, what is the net force? Equal to ma. Therefore R minus mg, it is moving upward, so this is greater than this. So R minus mg equal to ma, means R equal to mg plus ma plus mg. So if you take common R, then we will get R a plus a. So if you take common m, then R plus R equal to A plus M into A plus G. Clear? This. G plus A or R, A plus G, same thing. Next, you can take like this also. G plus A. It will be easy to memorize. G plus A. Now you see, lift is moving with uniform acceleration in upward direction. If it is moving downward direction, first case, lift is stationary, no change in weight. Second case, lift is moving with uniform motion upward or downward, then also there is no change in weight. Now, and third case is lift is moving upward with uniform acceleration A. In this case, we are getting R minus mg equal to ma. So R equal to ma plus mg, m take common, so g plus a. So weight is increasing. Weight is increasing. Suppose original weight is 60 kg weight. If it is moving upward, then it will increase, little bit increase. If you can practically feel in case of merry-go-round, chorki, if it move upward, then you will feel that the weight is increasing. Now, lift is moving downward. Lift is downward with acceleration, uniform acceleration A. Then what will happen? Net force, what will be the net force? Ma, F equal to ma, Newton's second law, F equal to ma. And it is moving downward now. It is moving downward. So it is moving in this direction now with acceleration A. So this is greater than this. So therefore mg minus R equal to ma. That means R equal to mg minus ma. m common g minus a. If move upward, weight increase. If move downward, weight decrease. You can easily feel, practically feel, if you merry-go-round. In the merry-go-round, you can easily feel this. When it will move down, you feel that your weight is decreasing, and you feel some problem also. This weight. When move up, weight increase. When move down, weight decrease. Now, hip case. When the lift is falling freely, free fall. When free fall, then A equal to G, free fall, A equal to G. Therefore, R equal to M into G minus A. A means G. So, equal to M into 0, equal to 0. So, the person will feel weightless. That means, in the weighing machine, he will see his reading is 0. His reading is 0. That means, the cord is cut. Cord is cut. He is falling freely. He is falling freely. Now another case is, this is the free fall. At the time of free fall, acceleration is equal to the gravitational acceleration. So if you put here, you will get this. Now suppose the lift is moving downward with acceleration which is greater than g. Fifth, sixth, lift is moving downward, lift is moving downward direction with acceleration A greater than G. Then put here, then R equal to G into, M into G minus A. But G minus A is negative. But because A is greater. But G minus A is negative. So R equal to negative. What does it mean? The passengers will move in the upward direction from the floor and stick to the roof, ceiling, that means ceiling, stick to the ceiling. When this situation happens, acceleration of the lift is greater than the acceleration due to gravity, then his weight will be negative, and due to which the persons or passengers cannot stay in the floor. They will move upward and stick to the ceiling of the lift. Okay, these are the six cases. First, lift is stationary. Second is lift is moving downward and upward direction with uniform motion. In these two cases, apparent weight remains the original weight. And when lift is moving upward with acceleration A, the weight is increasing. R equal to M into G plus A. And when the lift is moving downward with acceleration A, then weight decreasing. r equal to m into g minus a, and when the person see that the weight is zero, that means free fall, that means the cord of the lift is cut, and when the lift is moving downward with an acceleration which is greater than g, then the weight will be negative, and due to which the person cannot stay in the floor, they will move upward and stick to the ceiling of the lift. Okay, bye.